Art.
Good morning, everybody. Now we'll discuss about the next methodology of integration, that is the Simpson's one-third rule. Now what we can say about the Simpson's one-third method? It is basically used for polynomial of degree 2. Degree 2 means it is a quadratic equation. Quadratic equation in the form of x square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. If you have seen the quadratic equation, the index or maximum degree of polynomial of quadratic equation is 2. That means it requires minimum 3 points to join the curve by using the quadratic equation. Now how the method, this method is going to work? Now suppose I want to integrate I having a limits from x0 to xn f of x dx. Now how it will work, let us see. Suppose we will plot a graph of x versus f of x. Okay, now having we will plot a curve having a limits from x0 to xn. Now, first point is available, that is x0, y0. This last point is available, it is xn, yn. Now, to join by using the quadratic curve, we require three points are required. Therefore, this is called as the one major strip. In Simpson's one-third rule, each and every major strip is being divided into the two number of substrip. Each and every substrip will have the height of h. Okay, now I got this one more point here, x1 and y1, where x1 is equal to x0 plus h, x2 will be equal to x0 plus 2h. Now these points will be joined with the help of a polynomial of degree 2. Now this much is the error in the calculation, whatever the shaded portion is there. If you observe with the trapezoidal rule, the error is very much less here. Okay. Now the area in this method will be calculated by using the formula h by 3 into the bracket y0 plus 4 times of y1 plus y2. This is the area of one strip. Now let us see what will happen if there are two number of major strips are available. Now in Simpson's one-third method, every major strip is being divided into the two number of substrip. Now let us see, we'll take for the same limit x0 to xn. Now we'll take two number of major strips. Now this is the first major strip, this is the second major strip. Now in Simpson's one-third rule, each major strip is being divided into the two number of substrips. Now, every major strip is being divided into the two number of substrips, and it is being joined with the polynomial of degree 2. And we'll get the different points y0, y1, y2, y3, y4 corresponding x1, x2, x3, and that is equal to x4. Every strip will have a height of h. Every strip will have a height of h. Then what will be the total area? The total area will be calculated as, this is the first major strip, this is the second major strip. That is the area of first strip plus area of second strip. Now how to calculate the area of first strip? Let us see here. Area of first strip, that is h by 3 into y0 plus 4 times of y1 plus y2. And area of second strip will be equal to h by 3. Now the second strip is going to start from y2, y3 and y4. Therefore it will start from y2 plus 4 times of y3 plus y4. Therefore, the total area will be calculated as area of first strip plus second strip that will be equal to h by 3 into y0 plus 4 times of y1 plus y2 plus h by 3 into y2 plus 4 times of y3 plus y4. Now we have combined the two different area. We will take a common factor here, that is h by 3 into y0 plus 4 times of y1 plus y2 plus y2 plus 4 times of y3 plus y4. Now we will combine this. Again we will take a common factor for our simplicity, that is y0 plus y4 plus 4 times of y1 plus y3 plus 2 times of y2. Now we will write this formula in our simplified language. H by 3, that is the first term plus last term plus 4 into sum of odd terms plus 2 into sum of even terms. This is a common formula for the Simpson's one-third rule. This is our total area. Okay, now this this method we have studied. Now to get a better understanding, we'll try to solve some of the numerical based on this type of methodology. Now I think all of you will be ready with your calculators and your write-up pages. Now one thing I have missed, that is to explain how to calculate the value of h. H will be calculated as xn minus x0 divided by 2n, where n is nothing but number of major steps. In Simpson's one third rule, each and every major step is being divided into the two number of substrips. If two number of major steps are available, then how many steps will be, total number of steps will be available? Yes, anybody? How many major steps will be, if two number of major steps are there, then how many total number of steps will be available? That is 2 into 2, that will be the 4 number of major total steps will be available. Because in Simpson's one third rule, every major strip is being divided into the two number of substrips. Now let us solve some numerical based on that. Just note down the numerical. Evaluate the integration of evaluate the integration of 1 by x dx having a limits from 1 to 7 having a limits of 1 to 7 using two major strips. Now let me clear by using Simpson's one third rule. Using Simpson's one third rule, we are going to solve the numerical by using the two number of major strips for the integration of 1 by x dx having a limit from 1 to 7. Now Simpson's one third methodology, what it creates, every major strip is being divided into the two number of substrips. Okay, now here are two major strips are there, that means how many total number of strips will be there? 2 into 2 is equal to 4 number of total strips available. Now first of all, we'll calculate value of h. Now let us solve this. H will be equal to xn minus x0 divided by 2 times of n, that is 7 minus 1 divided by 2 into 2, that is 4, that is 6 divided by 4, that means it is 3 by 2. That's in simplified language, we can say it is a 3 by 2, that can be also written as 1.5. We can write it is a equal to 1.5. Now we'll prepare a table for this. What will be the table? Table consists of value of x and y. Okay, what is this y? Y is equal to 1 by x. What is value of x? X will range from x0 to xn having a distance between x equal to h. Therefore, we'll say x0. Now, x0 is equal to 1 x1 is equal to x0 plus h, that will be equal to 2.5. x2 will be equal to 2.5 plus 1.5, how much? 4. x3 will be equal to 4 plus 1.5, 5.5, and x4 will be equal to 5.5 plus 1.5, that will be equal to 7. Then the next one, we'll find a value of x. Y is equal to 1 by x, that will be equal to y0 will be equal to 1. Then similarly, y1 will be equal to 1 divided by 1.25, that value will be equal to 0.4. y2 will be equal to 1 divided by 4, that will be equal to 0.25. then y3 will be equal to 1 divided by 5.5, that value will be equal to 0.1818, and y4 is equal to 1 divided by 7, that value is equal to 0.1428. Now we'll write a formula for this. What are the formula we have already developed here? That is, total area is equal to area of first strip plus area of second strip. Total area is equal to area of first strip plus area of second strip. Now what is our formula? H by 3, okay, first term plus last term, that is y0 plus y4 plus 4 into sum of odd term, y1 plus y3, y1 plus y3 plus 2 times of even term, 2 times of y2. Therefore, what is the value of h? H is equal to 1.5 divided by 2, y0 is equal to 1, y4 is equal to
start.
Okay, 1.5 divided by 3 plus y0 plus y4, that is 1 plus 0.1428. plus 4 into 0.4 plus 0.1818 plus 2 times of 0.25. Now calculate this total area using your calculator. Final, you will get the final value is equal to 1.985. This is the final answer by using the Simpson's 1/3 rule. Similarly, you can solve different example based on this, but basic fundamental concept is that every major strip is being divided into the two number of sub strips. Okay, thank you. In the next lecture, we will discuss the next methodology, that is Simpson's 3/8 rule. Thank you.